So what you're going to need to clean your piercings is some Q-tips. Have some clean Q-tips. Make sure they're clean. And before you do any of this, make sure you wash your hands, especially if you have a new piercing. And then you're going to need some distilled water and some non-iodized sea salt. That's what I use to clean my piercing. I don't use anything else. There's different solutions that people will make to clean, and I've even heard people clean it with like alcohol and peroxide and things like that. But what I was instructed by a professional piercer was to get a gallon of distilled water and fill it with, I believe, 2 teaspoons of non-iodized sea salt, non-iodized salt, and then they do have sea salt as well. But just shake it up, and then you have a jug that's going to last you for a very long time. You don't need that much to clean your ear. And if you happen to have a lot of bumps, if you get a bump here from like bumping it or just the healing process, and if you get a bump here also from the healing process, because what happens is if you hit your nose or you hit your ear, there can be scar tissue that happens, but there's no room for that scar to form within the hole. So that's when you'll get something that looks like a bump on the outside of your ear or around your nose piercing. And this tea tree oil has saved my life. You can get this. I got mine off of Amazon. This is 4 ounces. I believe it was like $10, but it is worth it, okay? It's very, really, really worth it. You put a small amount of this on your bumps. I had a bump on the back of my ear, and I put it there. Within a few days, you could definitely see it going down, and then, like, no more bumps. Even after my bumps had healed, and, you know, I hit it again through the healing process, I just kept repeating the process whenever there was a bump. Or even if I slept on it the night before, I would wake up and clean it and then apply some tea tree oil just in case. And you don't need that much tea tree oil. Just take a little Q-tip portion and then, you know, dab it around the area where the bump is, or dab it around here where the bump is. But now I'm going to clean mine. And once you take that distilled water, you want to get a glass mug. Make sure it's glass. You don't want plastic or anything. Bag the glass mug. Put about, I would say, not even, just to fill up the bottom, just to cover the bottom of the cup. That's how little amount of water that you're going to end up needing to clean your piercing, depending on how dirty it is too, you know, being honest. So I usually have my mug here, and I warm it up for about 15 seconds, just so it will have some warmth to it. And then I just dip it inside of the cup here. I lean the cup to the side, and then dip my Q-tip in there. And then I usually start with my nose piercing, since it's the first one I see, and I just push it up a little bit from within inside my nose and clean around it. Try and get as much around as I can. And this is I have a pretty big diamond right here too as well. This was something bought. This is definitely not how big it is. It is after you've gotten your nose pierced. So I have to try harder to get around it, to clean it, but it's all good. And I'll actually be doing a video right after this of changing my nose piercing, so definitely stick around for that. And I'll probably have the, you know, video at the end of this video, so you can click on that afterwards if you're interested in seeing how to change your nose piercing. So that one is pretty much done for the front portion. Now we're going to do the inside. Usually I just of try to feel around. And when you can see it raising up like that, that's how you know you're getting it. And I just clean around there really, really good. And this feels really good too, by the way. It feels really good. If you go too deep, you may pull out a batter too, but it's all gravy. I wouldn't recommend picking your nose with one of these, because if you go too deep, you will get a nosebleed that will be real. So now I'm going to do my industrial, and I haven't cleaned my industrial in probably about 2 days. I usually clean it, try and clean it every day. And just because if I, like, even I had my industrial for almost a year now. July will be a year. My sister took me on my birthday, well, kidnapped me on my birthday and took me to go get my industrial piercing. She paid for it. Love you. Shout out to you, Tay. And going to be about a year this year in July, but even when I still sleep on it, I still wake up and it can still be sore, so, you know, or a lot of discharge will actually happen as well with the piercing. So don't be afraid of your discharge. Just get in there, clean it out, and move on with your life, you know? And I'll even show you some crust that accumulates. Usually it's like crust that accumulates here by the tip, the very top portion of it. Slept on. I didn't even realize that when I went to go get it. So definitely, if you're
thinking about getting one, take that into account as well. Now I'm going to clean the back portion. And just going around. I'm sorry, I'm trying to see if you can see what I'm doing. Q-tip again, because the moisture of the Q-tip helps get all of that dirt out. And I gotta come around this angle to clean the back side.
You ever see someone with a nose ring do that? They're not picking their nose, just scratching my post that's like sticking out right here. It just, or it tickles sometimes. Get another Q-tip
and just finish cleaning. And after I'm done making sure all of these are clean, I just go back around one last time to make sure everything is clean.
Also show you how I apply the tea tree oil. So I take this, tilt this to the side, very little bit on the Q-tip, and then I just dab, front back. I'm sorry, I don't know.
Clean industrial. Doesn't it look good?
Alright, so those are all of my tips for today. If you have any other suggestions or have any questions or anything, definitely comment down below and I can answer them. Please give this video a thumbs up, like, comment, and subscribe so you can be alert to the next video that we post and whenever we do post a video. And I'm also going to have the link or the video here showing you that I'll also have a video showing you how to change your nose piercing because I'm about to do that now. And yeah, thank you for joining me. And you know, always remember that you're beautiful and remember to smile and practice self-love. All right.